So vacancy, despite of
vacancy,
SSC is earning more than expectation of government of India. There is vacancy in the property, but still it is more than expectation of government of India. They are just expecting 1,20,000 per annum. SSC in 8 months have earned 1,60,000. They are happy with 1,60,000. They are happy with
1,60,000.
And they are asking SSC to pay tax on 1,60,000. Fair? Hello, can I go ahead? Yes, sir, it is fair. So no problem, sir. If even if vacancy is there and still actual rent is more than or equal to, more than or this equal to is also important, expected rent, then GAV is equal to, hello, tell me, GAV is equal to actual rent. This is the law, not which is higher. GAV is equal to actual rent. Sir, this is case 1. Now please understand case 2. Case 2 I am writing here. Case 2. Same case. Expected rent 1,20,000. Expected rent 1,20,000. Actual rent 20,000 per month. Okay, and this is per annum. Okay. Now vacancy period. Vacancy period is equal to 8 months. Vacancy period is equal to 8 months. You understood now? Alright. Now what will be my actual rent? Come on, tell me therefore. Hello. Vacancy period is 8 months. So actual rent per annum, actual rent only 4 months, right? So how much is that? 80,000, only 80,000. And if I compare this with the expected rent, what is my expected rent? 1 lakh. 10 lakh 20. By default, what will you take in exam? In exam, if you don't know this law, what will you take? Whichever is. Are my actual rent is 80,000 and expected rent is 1,20,000. You will take whichever is higher. This SSC will fight up to Supreme Court then. He will say, sir, that actual rent is lower only because, come on, only because of vacancy, and vacancy was genuine. How will you prove vacancy was genuine? Simply you can take electricity bill to income tax department. Because the property was vacant. Nobody can stay in property without electricity. Hello. Alright, so you can produce electricity bill and show, sir, property was actually vacant. I'm not lying, sir. Okay, these are the 8 months electricity bill. See, electricity bills are not, electricity was not consumed. That means my property was vacant. And these two are my neighbors, sir. You ask them. What else I should bring? My property was genuinely vacated, sir. Department will say, okay, we will check that. Whether you are genuinely saying property was vacated and whether your actual rent is genuinely lower than our expectation or not. Hello? So that they have to check. Sir, whenever actual rent is lower than expected rent, then only there will be a problem. If actual rent is higher than expected, then there won't be any problem. But if actual rent is lower than expected rent, then there will be a problem. Alright? And whenever actual rent is lower than expected rent, please understand, Government of India will check whether that lower amount is only because of vacancy or because of some other reason. Only because of vacancy or because of some other reason. If it is only because of vacancy, then government will say pay tax on actual rent. Pay tax on
actual rent.
How to check that, sir? To check that, actual rent plus vacancy period rent. Actual rent plus
vacancy
period rent shall be more than or equal to expected rent. So no, ye 12 mahina agar let out hota. अब नहीं है, होता तो कितना कमाता? Can you tell me this number? If it was let out for whole 12 month, then how much would be this number?
2,40,000.
Is it more than 1,20,000?
Yes.
Yes, because 80,000 actual rent and 8 month vacancy. 8 month
vacancy.
So here I am putting that data. Actual rent 80,000. Actual rent plus vacancy rent 1,60,000. Is it more? And what is my expected rent? 1 lakh. Is it more than expected rent?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir. It is more than equal to expected rent. And therefore, government said, do not pay tax on expected rent. Pay tax on GAV is equal to actual rent. And actual rent here is
80,000.
Actual rent here is
80,000.
Which law you did not follow? Come on, tell me. Which law you did not follow? Whichever is higher law. By default, what will you follow? Whichever is higher. Am I following here whichever is higher? Am I following whichever is higher? Come on, tell me.
No.
Sir. GAV is equal to what? GAV is equal to what? GAV is equal to AR. Star wala. AR. Just last case. Alright, just last case. Listen, please. Alright. If my actual rent was 5,000. Actual rent was per month 5,000. Here same case. If actual rent is 5,000, just tell me what will be the number. 40,000. My actual rent will become. Hello. 8 month vacancy. 8 month vacancy. Please understand. And 4 month let out. And 5,000 per month rent. 80,000 will be total rent. 80,000. Listen. Here I'll write here. Case 3. Actual rent is equal to 5,000 rupees per month. Alright. Let out period, please understand. Let us take let out period 10 month. Okay. And vacancy period 2 month. What is my actual rent? Unexpected rent is equal to 1,20,000. What is my actual rent? Come on, tell me. 50,000. Alright. Now what I'm asking government, you know. Sir, mera actual rent is lower than your expected rent. Only because of vacancy. Government say, okay, we will check. How government will check? Come on, tell me. We will check. Is it only because of vacancy or not? Kaisa check karega? Bolo na. Actual rent plus vacancy rent should be more than equal to expected rent. To batao, actual rent 50,000. Vacancy rate add karta to kitna ho jata? 10,000. So total is 60,000. Is it higher or lower?
Sir,
it is lower than expected rent. It is? Tum chor ho sir. Aap kon ho? Aap chor ho. Aap kya ho? Chor ho. Aap samajh rahe ho? Hello. And whenever you are chor, GAV is equal to expect rent. GAV is equal to यहाँ पे भी तो वही हो रहा था. Whenever your AR is lower than ER, what do we take? Whenever your actual rent is lower than expect, what do we take? Because what is our assumption? You are showing lower actual rent. You are showing and minimum taxable value in house property is expected rent. Alright. So what should I write here? Whenever actual rent plus vacancy rent. Whenever actual rent plus is lower than expected rent. Government, because here this value is lower, not only because of vacancy, there are more factors to it. Even if your property was not vacated, still your actual rent would have been lower than expected rent. Are vacancy nahi hota, phir bhi tera actual rent kya hota? Lower than expected. Tu pehle se chor tha. Alright. And therefore your GAV will be equal to expected rent. Hello. So please understand, please, last. When there is no vacancy, when there is?
No vacancy.
We take expected rent or actual rent, whichever is higher. Very simple?
Yes.
Are both easy? Yeah. Alright. Yes. Am I clear? Yes. Alright. If there is vacancy, yeah, but vacancy is not making your actual rent lower than expected rent. Their actual rent is still higher than expected rent. And what is the case? Case is this, 160, 120. Yeah. 8 mahine ka 160, 12 mahine ka your expectation 120. Am I earning more than your expectation in 8 months? Yes. And even if you don't know this law, what will you take? Whichever is higher. Whichever is higher. And whichever higher will be 160, isn't it? Are even if you don't know this law, still your answer will be right here. Hello. Last case. Case number 3, please understand. Even if you don't know this law, if you ignore this law, actual rent is 50,000. Unexpected rent is 120. What will you take? Whichever is higher. And what is that number? 1 lakh? Still it will be the right number?
Yes.
Legally wrong. But accidentally right.
Yes.
Alright. That whichever is higher will not work only in this case. Where? Whenever actual rent is lower than expected rent only because of vacancy. In this case it will not operate. Am I clear? And how do we check this? Actual rent plus vacancy rent should be more than equal to expected rent. And if this is the case, if this particular amount is higher than this amount, then we assume assessee is earning actual rent lower than expected rent only because of vacancy. Only one reason is there, vacancy. Vacancy ki wajah se wo kam kama raha hai, which is genuine reason. And therefore we don't take whichever is higher. We say whatever is your actual rent, we will pay tax on that. Alright. And here therefore, if you take whichever is higher in exam, only in this situation, 120-80, if you take whichever is higher, then that will be a wrong answer. Because here GAV is 80,000. Hello? Alright. You people write down the chart one more time. Like you write down, I will explain one more time.